Hello! Today, I will show you some practical uses for batch process in Clip Studio Paint for tablets. Please note that batch process is only available on Clip Studio Paint EX. There are times when we need to apply a filter, or a transformation, or an automatic action to a large number of files. For example, maybe we're making a multi-page comic or a webtoon and need to add some final touches. Or maybe we need to edit a series of images for, let's say, a portfolio. Doing it by hand can be very time-consuming. My favorite thing when I work is finding ways of spending less time clicking mindlessly and more time just drawing. Batch process is a great tool for this, since it will save us lots of time and prevent any inconsistencies from happening. Let's look at the main window first, and then we'll see some practical uses where we can apply this tool. To access batch process, click on the file menu and look for the batch process option. This will open a new window. You will see here on the left side of this window, we have the commands and options we can apply to our files. Basically, here on the left side, we tell Clip Studio what it will be doing to each file. Here at the top, we can choose between main menu and automatic actions. Main menu will show us commands from the file, edit, layer, select, view, and filter menus. Automatic actions will show all available actions to choose from. After we choose what we are going to ask Clip Studio to do, we must tell it to which files it will apply these commands. The options you will see as available on the upper right side of the window will depend on how many files are open and what kind of files they are. Let me show you. If you have a comic or a webtoon file open, the options All Pages and Selected Pages will be available. If you have one or more individual files open, options Open Canvases and Current Canvas will be available. Finally, on the lower right half of the window, we will tell Clip Studio if and where to save these files. We can either close without saving, save and close, or save as and close. As an additional option for these three, we can choose not to close the open canvases. So that's the window. Now I will show you three cases where we can use batch process in different ways. Case number one, a comic book or a graphic novel. Let's say I made a graphic novel, but then when I printed a test, I figured out that some of the colors came out a little too dark. And as a result, I have to do some color correction in all the pages. And I could do adjustment page by page for the 152 pages and waste a lot of time. This is where batch process comes in. Let's open the image files I exported from my Clip Studio Paint comic file. I will first duplicate my folder to create a backup before I edit, just in case. I strongly recommend that you always create a duplicate folder when you use batch process, just so you will not lose your original files in case you do something that's not completely to your liking. I will open all of them on Clip Studio Paint and click on batch process. For this, I will choose Edit, Color Correction, Brightness Contrast, and I will set the other options to Open Canvases and Save and Close, so these files will be overwritten. After I click on OK, I will be prompted to make the first adjustment. I think this amount of brightness and contrast would look better in print. Once I am happy with it, I click OK, and I will get a new window asking me about the next batch process. Here we have three options. If I select the middle one, Show the Settings dialog each time, I will be able to edit brightness contrast differently for each page. Now, there might be pages I want to exempt from this process. To do that, I can select Skip when I reach those specific pages, and choose OK. Since now I want to apply the color correction to the rest of the pages equally, I will select both Continue and Don't Show This Dialog Again. This will run the commands straight through all the open files without stopping. Be careful with the files you're editing so you don't get an unexpected result. And again, always make a backup of your project, just in case. And that's it! All files corrected, and it was only over a minute. Let's compare how much time it saves me to use batch process. How long would it have taken me if I had to edit these files by hand? See? This time I can use to draw more or go get some water. Let's look at case number 2, a webtoon. Batch process can also be used to give the final touches to a webtoon episode. Maybe you give your images a special finish, for example, adding a slight blur to make it look dreamy, or sharpening the entire image so it looks clear when loading on a website. For this, I will use automatic actions. Personally, I find automatic actions to be a lifesaver when working with assistants. This way, I don't have to worry about them writing the wrong number when doing a Gaussian blur or using the exact color code when changing a layer's color. An automatic action will work the same way every single time. I just send my assistants a group of actions, they click play, and that's it. It has saved me so many worries, and it has saved them precious time too, because it doesn't take as long for them to make the adjustments I need. For this file, I will record an action that combines all visible layers into a new layer, and then applies a Gaussian blur, changes the blending mode to overlay, and then changes that layer's opacity to 25%. Once I'm happy with my action, I will stop recording and leave only the main file of my webtoon open. Then, I will bring up the batch process window. I'll choose automatic actions from the drop-down menu on the upper left, and select my final touches action. I will set apply to all pages and save options to save and close. And that's it! The effect was added to all my pages in seconds and without worrying or having variations that would have had to be corrected later on by hand. Finally, let's move on to case number 3, a portfolio or a series of images. There's always a case where you need to resize a ton of images and then add the same element to each of them, like for example logo or text. Let's say there is a client who asked me to deliver all these files with a copyright disclaimer in the lower left corner. I will first make the copyright image, hide the paper layer, and then save it as a .png so it has a transparent background. Then I will open one of the files I have to edit to record the action. I will then import the image with the text. Importing a file can be recorded as an automatic action. Just be very careful not to move this file from its original folder, or the path to the file will be broken and the action will not work as intended. I will align the image to the bottom left corner using the Align palette, and then I will flatten the image. Once I've stopped recording and saved the action, I will open all the images to edit and then the batch process window. Here I will select my action, apply to open canvases, save and close, but I will select not to close the open canvases so we can see the result. I hit OK to run batch process, and here's my images. And these are just 3 cases where you might find batch process useful, but depending on your workflow, there are so many more. Whether you knew of this tool beforehand or not, I hope these practical examples of the batch process window have helped you understand better how it works. And I hope you can use it in the future to save time on your projects. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye!
Clip Studio Paint.